So in the salary problem, let's go ahead and assume that for the first year we're making $50,000. When we find the formula, we'll be able to replace that with M. So in year 0, we're making $50,000. After 1 year, we get 5% of that $50,000 added to that $50,000, which gives us a total of $52,500. After another year, we get 5% of now our new amount of the $52,500. So we actually get a larger raise than the year before to give us a total of $55,125. After another year, we get a raise of 5% on the $55,125, and we get a total of $57,881.25. So each year we go up, we're getting an increase of 5% on what we made the year before. So we can use that to fill in our table. So we see that after 6 years of working for the company, we're going to be making $67,004.78. Notice we do not have a constant rate of change. What we have is an increasing rate of change. So we were able to do this for each year. Each year we went up by 5% of the year before. So to get to each next salary, actually what's happening is we're taking the year before and we're actually multiplying by 1.05. 50,000 times 1.05 is 52,500. Multiply by 1.05 again, and we get the next year. So each year we increase, we're actually multiplying by 1.05. So what we have is repeated multiplication by 1.05. Let's see how we can come up with a formula for this. So we start off at $50,000, and multiplying by 1.05 once gives us our salary after 1 year. Now, we multiply by 1.05 again to get our salary after year two, and notice that if we're multiplying by 1.05 twice, we can actually write that as 1.05 squared. So for each additional year we work there, we're multiplying by an additional 1.05. So each time we get another year of service, we're just increasing that exponent on 1.05. So if we wanted to generalize this for T years, then our salary would be 50,000 times 1.05 to the T. Now let's talk a little bit about where that 1.05 came from. So we're going to talk about growth factors. So in our example, our salary went up by 5% each year. So our new salary was equal to our old salary plus 5% of our old salary. Or we could think of it as being 100% of our old salary plus 5% of our old salary. So our new salary is 105% of our old salary, which as a decimal is 1.05. We call this 1.05 an annual growth factor. As we just saw, that 1.05 is the number we're repeatedly multiplying by to get each next salary. Notice that it's growing because it's greater than 1. So this is how repeated multiplication gives us an exponential function, and how we can find an exponential function by finding that constant percent change.